back to another Minecraft video on the Adults Craft Bedrock server. And as you can see, we are up in the top quarter of the base, and it is now all grass. I have finally taken the time to swap it out from the stone to the grass. You may also notice that we are playing with some new shaders that look a bit funky depending on how we look. But I do like the way they look. Everything looks so lovely and pretty, and the sky looks amazing in them. So I'm going to play with them for this video, and we'll see what we think of them. I mean, look at the water. Look at the water, it looks lovely. I'll put a link down below for the name of the shaders and etc. But look at the sunset on the mountains. Let's just enjoy that for a second. So, we are going to be building over here today. What I'm planning on doing is getting a chicken cooker in up the back there. It's going to be something a bit different for the design, but we'll look at that in a minute. So, first off, it's time to get the music on and get the building built for what's going inside it. So we are back, and as you can see, I've got the front of the building done now, and I've also been in and put the floor in place. I don't know what's going on with all the animals. I think these slabs are confusing them, and they're pathfinding in and then not knowing what to do. But what we're going to do is come up the back. As you can see, I've kind of laid out where I want the chicken cooker to go, and sort of worked out levels and things for it. So first off, I am going to need to be putting in the pickup system. So let's just take these out, and I'm going to need to run a feed line that way. So I'm going to put a hopper there and a hopper beside it, and then come round the other side and do the same again. That's too low. That's too low. What I need to do is take it up one more. So in the middle. Yeah, there. So putting in the hopper lines, I'm just going to put face one out the back and then put one on either side of it. We can take that out for now. And get a wee bit of a stairway going up so we can get up onto this. I do need some slabs, that's what I need. I need a couple of slabs to go with it. So I should have some in that box, and the site slabs will do the job. So all we're going to do is come back in past all these mobs that have been spawning. if we jump up. So middle hopper, just gonna put a full block on it, and then these two here, oops, crouch placing slabs onto them. And then right behind that, we're going to want two dispensers, one behind each slab, like so. And let's chuck in a couple of torches so we can see what we're doing. So behind all of that, I am going to probably put in, going to take some of this wall out just to give us some space and give us a wee bit of a pad. That was too low, that was in the wrong place. Just to give us a wee bit of space to work from. Got a sheep coming up to visit us, and so we want a solid block between the dispensers, and now we can just grab up. So first things first, you're going to want a comparator out the back of that one and out the back of that one, like so. Then what we'll want is a repeater there, and repeaters coming out the back of those, and then we'll just run redstone dust like that. So what we should see is if we chuck that in there, it will fire it out the back, and that will give us our chicken spawning mechanism basically. So now we just need to grab our hoppers again and crouch place one on top of each, and then grab our glass. So what we're going to, I'm going to do is I'm going to put two panes of glass there in front of the slab and another two in front of that one there, and then just fill in the rest round about it. So one, two, and another one, two there, and one if I can get it in the middle like that. Can also fill in these ones. So next up, you're going to need your buckets of lava. So one goes on that one, one goes on that one, and then what I am going to do is cap those off just to keep it safe. You do need to also be capping off round about these hoppers so we can stop the chickens getting out. Just fill that one in as well. I am going to come up two on them just to keep it nice and safe. So that is the bulk of it done, and it should look like that at the front. So now we can take out these bits, and that row there I'm going to take out as well. As you can see, it's hollow underneath. So that is it, basically finished. Looks a bit funky, but we can adjust with that. Now all you need to do is get yourself a lot of eggs. So we'll go and grab some of them. Right, so I have got a shulker box of eggs, so all I'm going to do is just pillar up beside the two of these here and stick my box down. We will grab a whole load of eggs out of here, and all we're going to do is aim sort of down into the hole and throw the eggs so that we fill this up with some chickens. Right then, so that should do us for chickens. So now all we need to wait is for them to grow up. So while we're waiting on that, I am going to go and decorate up the front of this so it looks a bit more like a chicken and less like some kind of weird demon structure. So we'll be back once we've done that and we've got some chickens on the go. Right, so we are back and as you can see, done a bit of landscaping out front and I have put some gates on just to solve my animal problem inside. I'm growing up some birch trees just to continue with the landscaping around about here because as you can see I've done a bit down here and need fit in the best, so I need more saplings, so I thought I'd just grow them out. But we've got this all pretty much done. Do need to do some more landscaping around about. Need to run a path from here over to connect to there. Same with once we decide what's going over there, the path can continue away. But anyway, if we head inside, so I'll shut that. So I've got the chicken cooker in and decorated, kind of kept it fairly simple because I quite like the way the grey concrete just kind of goes into black as we look up. So kept simple, got the double chicken cooker there, kind of looks a bit like a chicken. I might do a bit more detailing with the stone and add some other variants in, but we'll see. And then we've just got the what is actually just, I think you can see it, netherrack on fire there. Nothing fancy there, but looks kind of cool. I've added some pillars in just to give it a bit of shape inside, but again, I don't want to do too much because I do like that kind of feel, like it's just going into the void sort of feeling. And I've added these little pods in, and this is going to basically be for a museum. So when we get something that we want to display or something that, you know, has a bit of meaning, we can put it in here. So the first one I'm going to put in is the wither rose that we got from Grandpa on stream. Put that in. If you weren't watching the stream, then this is basically what happened. So, yep, we had quite a bit of fun on stream doing various things, and when we were over at Frankie's theme park one of the days, Grandpa came over because he just finished his farm and gave us a wee demonstration of the Wither Rose's power. So, yeah, that's us all pretty done. I've used some of the birch on the inside. I'm not sure about the doorway, it looks a bit messy and too busy with all the different textures there, so I may clean it up and go something a bit closer to that kind of design for it, but we'll see. Kind of been throwing these raid banners about because we've had quite a lot of patrols recently, but it's not really the overall theme of it. So yeah, it is all now done. If we take a wee jump off and hopefully be able to fly. Possibly needs a bit more work at the top of the pillars and stuff to kind of merge them in a bit better. But I think it fits in quite nicely. Might make those windows taller as well. But yeah, it's something nice and big that fits the space. It leaves about here where I'm probably going to put a garden or like a something like that. Maybe another pond up there. Because the beacon will obviously be moved, but yeah, and I think the contrast in colour adds very nicely to when you come through the portal. So you have the nice big white tower. I really need to fill that hole in, and I think that's just a lighting glitch up there, but it gives it a bit of depth to it. So I think wait. I think that works really nicely. Didn't even get in the water. Oh, Frankie is I know, look at the night sky in this packet, it's lovely. Even the normal sky is lovely. So I think for today that is going to do it. As always, if you've got any suggestions for things that I can do to the build to add to it, do drop them in the comments below. And if you enjoyed the video, hit the thumbs up button. And as always, if you're enjoying the content on my channel, please do consider subscribing. It helps me out a lot. And I will see you next time. Goodbye.